Today, I'm going to teach you the plural suffix where and how it appears in Turkish language. The plural suffix is ler or lar depending on the vowel harmony, and it follows the two-way vowel harmony. First of all, this suffix is used to make singular nouns plural. Now, here is the brief explanation of the two-way vowel harmony once again. In Turkish, there are 8 vowels: a, e, ı, i, o, ö, u, ü. If the last vowel of a word is a, ı, o, or u, then we use lar. And if the last vowel of a word is e, i, ö, or ü, then we use ler. Here are some examples: aile, aileler; araba, arabalar; kedi, kediler; kapı, kapılar; göz, gözler; pantolon, pantolonlar; gün, günler; okul, okullar. As I have mentioned so many times, the main purpose of this is to keep the shape of the mouth in a particular way for easy pronunciation. But of course, there are some exceptions. There are words, loan words, coming from other languages that we use in Turkish. And sometimes these words do not follow this general rule. Here are some of them, and then I will explain why this happens. Kontrol, kontroller; saat, saatler; kabul, kabuller; rol, roller. Some of the loan words end in palatalized consonants. This means when these consonants are pronounced, part of the tongue is moved close to the hard palate. You would usually see this with le and t. When a word which normally would receive lar as a plural suffix, because of this palatalized consonant, it receives ler instead. Now, let's take a look at one of the examples once again. Kabul, kabul. The last le is palatalized. Kabul. If it was not palatalized, I would pronounce this word like this: kabul, kabul. Hear the difference: kabul, kabul, kabul, kabul. Because it's pronounced as kabul, it receives ler as a plural suffix. The same situation goes for the other examples as well. Now, let's move on. Here is another way how we use plural suffixes. We attach the plural suffix to the name of a person and nouns of kinship. When we do that, we produce an expression that refers to the group which is associated with that person. This group may consist just the named person and his or her spouse or partner, or it could be their family, group of friends, and sometimes their house or place. For example, Mehmet yarın İstanbul'a gidecek. Mehmet yarın İstanbul'a gidecek. This means Mehmet will go to Istanbul tomorrow. When we say Mehmetler yarın İstanbul'a gidecek, Mehmetler yarın İstanbul'a gidecek. Now, what this means is Mehmet and his family or his friends will go to Istanbul tomorrow. Another example: bu akşam arkadaşlarla Gökçenler'de kalacağız. Bu akşam arkadaşlarla Gökçenler'de kalacağız. Another one: dün yürürken aslıhanları gördük. Dün yürürken aslıhanları gördük. This use is very common in daily conversations. And now, a couple of examples with the nouns of kinship. Amcamlar haftaya bizi ziyaret edecek. Amcamlar haftaya bizi ziyaret edecek. This means my uncle and his family are going to visit us next week. Here, as you see, the plural suffix is attached to the word amcam, which means my uncle. Therefore, amcamlar means my uncle and his family. But if we say amcalarım haftaya bizi ziyaret edecek. Amcalarım haftaya bizi ziyaret edecek. In this case, the plural suffix is attached to the word amca, and then the possessive suffix "-ım is attached to it. Amcalarım. And this means my uncles. So, the meaning of the sentence will be, my uncles are going to visit us next week. As you may know, in Turkish, we use the terms amca and teyze for older people that we know who are not part of our family. For example, let's say my mom has a friend named Ayşegül and I refer to her as Ayşegül teyze. In this case, the same situation applies once again. Ayşegül teyzeleri markette gördüm. Ayşegül teyzeleri markette gördüm. This means I saw Aunt Ayşegül and her family, friends at the market. Here is another use of the plural suffix, which is actually very interesting. The first plural personal pronoun, biz, and the second plural personal pronoun, siz, can be used with the plural suffix, such as bizler and sizler. This is not very common and used in the following circumstances. When the speaker wants to highlight the individual members of a group, especially to show that each person acted or experienced something on their own. Here's an example. Bizler sınavda başarısız olunca çok üzüldük. Bizler sınavda başarısız olunca çok üzüldük. In addition, this is used to refer to multiple groups of people like this. Sizler, İstanbullular ve İzmirliler, denizin olmadığı yerde yaşayamazsınız. Sizler, İstanbullular ve İzmirliler, denizin olmadığı yerde yaşayamazsınız. And when we speak with somebody formally using siz, we use this form to refer to a group that this person belongs to. And not just that person only. This group could be a family or friends or something else. For example, when somebody whom I address formally using siz asks me, nasılsın? Nasılsın? I would reply, iyiyim, teşekkürler. İyiyim, teşekkürler. And then I would ask, siz nasılsınız? Siz nasılsınız? Formally. With this question, I would ask how this person is only. However, when I ask, sizler nasılsınız? Sizler nasılsınız? Using the plural suffix attached to siz, now I'm asking how this person and his or her family are. Sizler nasılsınız? Sizler nasılsınız? Now to the next point. In Turkish, most of the time, the greeting words and words for good wishes receive the plural suffix. İyi günler, iyi akşamlar, iyi geceler. İyi tatiller, iyi yolculuklar, iyi dersler, başarılar. As you see, the plural suffix appears in these expressions. And lastly for today, I would like to show you the order in which nominal inflectional suffixes appear on the word stem. So, the word stem, and then the plural suffix, and then the possessive suffix, and the case suffix. And of course, a buffer letter may be necessary between the possessive suffix and the case suffix. Here's an example. Arabalarımı. Arabalarımı. Dün arabalarımı sattım. Dün arabalarımı sattım. Another one. Çiçeklerine. Çiçeklerine. Çiçeklerine su verdi. Çiçeklerine su verdi. There is one exception to this suffix order, and I actually talked about it a couple of minutes ago. Remember the difference between amcamlar and amcalarım. Amcamlar and amcalarım. As you see, when we say amcamlar, the possessive suffix is actually before the plural suffix, and you already learned the difference a couple of minutes ago in this video. So, there are actually many other ways where the plural suffixes appear, and I will cover them in the second part of this video later. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you have any questions, let me know. See you in the next videos.